Hi, good evening, welcome back. Brand new week, quite sort of a Tuesday today, not Monday. Missed uploading, rather even recording a video yesterday because I think, as I told you on Friday, this is going to be a hectic week. Hectic in the sense that we have a function in our family. It's my cousin's wedding on Thursday. So a lot of to and fro visits to the houses and wedding hall and all those things. So yesterday, most of the day we were at my cousin's place because there was one particular ritual that happened yesterday, first half of the day. It kind of went till in the evening. So we came back once, took some rest, and then again went back again in the night for the mehndi function. That's good. Anyway, quick update. Again, it was late and I just didn't have enough energy to come back and record something, edit and upload. So I kind of intentionally told myself not to switch on the camera or do anything last night. Then going back to how was the weekend, the best thing about the weekend was doing something for the very first time. I know it sounds a little bit cliched and very commonly heard, but this time around, after almost 2 weeks of postponing and replanning and cancellation and all those things, we went for a breakfast drive. Now, breakfast drive is not something very new to us, and like me, my wife and my kid, we usually, before this all this COVID thing happened, every like once in a month or twice a month, we used to go out on a Sunday morning, say maybe to like go to Cubbon Park for some time and then go to MTR or somewhere and have breakfast and come back. But because of all this COVID stuff, we had like kind of brought it to zero. But after a very long time, we went for a breakfast drive. And why I told doing something for the very first time is because this breakfast drive was for not outside of our area, not outside of our city, but outside of our state as well, because we went all the way till Krishnagiri to have our breakfast. And we are talking about like approximately about like 90 kilometers. I forgot how long the drive was, but it's definitely around 90-95 kilometers from home. So it was something which I've been planning for like last 2-3 weeks. There was a specific shop called Murugan Idli Shop, which is famous for their, obviously, the idli, and most specifically the podi idli, or the chutney podi idli, as I can say as a Kannadiga. It's a very unique thing that they do. It's very unique and good taste. So I had an option about like, I think almost a year back, where some of my riding friends had gone there for a breakfast ride. But I don't know why I missed that drive. But almost 2-3 weeks, I've been thinking at least I'll go on a ride or whatever. Because if I had gone alone, I would have definitely gone in my bike. And then I think 2 weeks back, I had almost finalized that we'll go, all three of us will go, but somehow it got cancelled. Then I just kept quiet, but suddenly on Friday we realized that, okay, we'll go to breakfast. So Saturday morning we got up. We thought we'll leave early so that we can go early and finish off and come back sooner. But we eventually left at around 9 o'clock in the morning. So we reached there by around 10:30, which is quite late, I would say, for a drive. And that too, we are driving towards Chennai and facing eastward direction. So it was very bright and very sunny, and kind of, I would say, a little bit challenging to drive because, again, that's not a time to start a trip. So that's what I would say. But the place was good, and the food was fantastic. Liked all the things that I tried. For some reason, I was in such a casual or chill out mood that I wanted to try whatever is there. So I kept on trying the normal idli, the podi idli, the dosa, the pongal, the sweet pongal, everything. And even ended off with a couple of things like coffee, filter coffee, and the jigatanda, which is again one of their unique juice or milkshake that you can call it. So had all of that, but as I don't know if it is only that, but as an end result of all those heavy eating and all those things, when I check back my weight today after almost a week, it's shocking. I mean, I have put on about like some 600-700 grams since the last 1 week, which is terrible, I would say. I mean, I know what effort it takes to bring down the weight, all the food changes and all the compromises you have to make and all. But again, I think I played easy on the compromises part over the last maybe 1 month. I spoke about it last week. I mean, it's all in the mind. It's nothing to do with exercise, wake up and all those things. But last 2 weeks, the exercise has been a little bit haphazard, I would say, because I mean, I've not been been going out for some personal work. So I'm supposed to leave in the morning, early in the morning. So I'm skipping the cycling and all the stuff. In fact, like in the last, I would say almost 1.5-2 weeks, I've gone to cycling only once, which is terribly wrong. And walking also has got reduced. So I'm pretty sure that's the case tomorrow and the after tomorrow as well. Maybe I can try going for a walk tomorrow. Definitely not on Thursday, because Thursday pretty early we had to reach the wedding hall, which is quite close by, not very far, but again I can't afford to go for a walk or cycling. So I have to make up my mind and start concentrating on my food habits and what I eat and how much I eat and how frequently I eat and all those things. And also the same is the case with exercise. I think I'm feeling very guilty about not following things very religiously. I've taken it very easily since almost Dasara time, and this is not good. I had a very big ambition for the new year, I mean at least the 45 days leading to new year in the middle of November, when I started on 16th of November to be precise, that's last Monday. But again, seeing this 1 kg extra added, 750 grams, that means I have to put an extra effort to bring that down and then start my journey again to reduce some more weight. My heart says that I should not give up and I should keep up the spirit and I should try for that one magic number that I'm looking at for the 1st of January timeline. Let's see how well it goes. But yeah, after this next two days is going to be crazy, and there's no way I can do anything related to the food or the exercise part. But I have to be very conscious about what I eat and how much I eat so that I can fall back to the proper routine from Friday, hopefully. Okay. And we're casually thinking about a travel plan in the mid of December also. So, but that is okay. That's not a place where we eat random junk food or sweets and all the stuff. The next 2 days is hectic, because again, yesterday I ate a little bit of sweets. So that's what I'm guilty about. So that's exactly what I wanted to touch upon, the breakfast drive of 90 kilometers which we did on Saturday, and again my priorities for this week and the health update. One other small topic that I want to touch upon is this, it's kind of like a very personal and I would say sensitive topic, but I'm just like, day in and day out, the more I see all this crazy thing that people do in the family circle, the so-called relative. Okay, I've spoken about it I think a week or two back, but again, I seriously feel why, where, when, how all this negativity comes into people's mind, like about treating someone bad or making someone feel bad or all this ego, selfishness and all. Because over the last maybe like 2 days, I've been seeing some evident things happening in front of my eyes in the function house. Where certain people or a certain person is behaving a little bit differently than what I expected. Because the same thing when I speak to my family, like especially like my mom and my sis, they say it is normal, it is expected from that person. But again, maybe I had not seen it from this perspective, but the way in which this person is behaving and reacting to things and doing things, I'm not happy. And again, considering that some of my family members are getting affected because of that, and in turn I'm getting mentally affected, it kind of bothers me that, like, why do people behave so selfishly and egoistically and all. But gotta live with it. I mean, I hope, like, I mean, it's not just with us, it's like the person is doing with few other people also, and their own family members as well, to be more precise. But I just hope, like, I mean, as my sister rightly said, once this wedding thing is over on Thursday, just close the door, that's it. Like, don't break your head on it, because there won't be much of an interaction that is required after that. And let them do, think or talk whatever they want. Just like maintain some distance from them. I think that's exactly what I have to do. So maintain some distance from them and just live myself, my life myself. So, I mean, I've told my wife also to play safe during the function over the next 2 days. So let's see how things goes. So I'm not really sure how things will go tomorrow and the after tomorrow regarding the uploads. So maybe I'll come back tomorrow and upload, or maybe on Thursday, or I might summarize it on Friday. So, but definitely I'll be back and I'll update you how things were during the function. So until we meet again, take care and bye-bye.